Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going. We don't dilute your video watching experience in this channel with sponsored products. If you like what we're doing, kindly support us on Patreon. www.patreon.com/defenseupdates. The Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II, which is a single-seat, single-engine, all-weather stealth multirole fighter, is undergoing final development and testing by the United States. The Pentagon began the F-35 program in 2001 with an aim to develop a cost-effective replacement for the U.S. military's F-15 fighters, F-16 and F-18 bombers and reconnaissance aircraft, and A-10 close-air support warplanes. Apart from the United States, the primary customer and financial backer, the United Kingdom, Italy, the Netherlands, Canada, Turkey, Australia, Norway, and Denmark are also part of the program. Many other nations like Japan and Israel are also deploying the fighter. The 9 major partner nations, including the U.S., plan to acquire over 3,000 F-35s through 2035, which, if delivered, will make the F-35 one of the most numerous jet fighters. The fighter aircraft will be in service until 2050. On the 2nd of August, 2016, the U.S. Air Force declared its first squadron of F-35A fighters combat ready. S-400 Triumph is an anti-aircraft weapon system developed by Russia's Almaz Central Design Bureau in the 1990s as an upgrade of the S-300 family. It's been in service with the Russian Armed Forces since 2007. It's designed to defend against aircrafts including 5th-generation stealth fighters, bombers, AWACS, cruise missiles, and ballistic missile. It's considered one of the most powerful anti-aircraft defense systems in the world. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the outcome when F-35 is pitted against the S-400. In a combat environment, the F-35 has the following options to defeat S-400. Number 1, outrun. Number 2, outmaneuver a missile. Number 3, stealth to avoid detection. Number 4, use EW suit to jam S-400. And number 5, long-range preemptive standoff strike. We'll analyze each of these one by one and rate the chances F-35 has against S-400 on a scale of 5.
Number 5.
In the past, we've seen this tactic being applied successfully when in April of 1986, SR-71 Blackbird outran SA-2 surface-to-air missile over Libya. But in case of F-35, the tactics will be useless since it has a top speed of only 1.6 Mach and missiles deployed by S-400 have hypersonic speeds ranging from 6 Mach to 14 Mach. For example, 40N6 missile has a speed of 14 Mach.
Number 4.
F-35 is not designed to be a great dogfighter and lacks agility when compared to fighters like F-22 or Su-35. The need for the small F-35 to carry a heavy range of internal engines, fuel, and weapons has resulted in what aviation experts labels as a high wing loading. Essentially, the wings are small in relation to its weight, and this impedes its maneuverability. F-35 also has a sluggish rate of climb when compared to modern fighters. The missile deployed by S-400 are not only guided by the system, but also have homing capabilities. For example, 40N6 has active radar homing and 48N6DM has semi-active radar homing head. These missiles are very agile and F-35 will find it hard to outmaneuver these missiles. The ability to twist, turn, and accelerate is a desperate but vital last-moment component of countermeasures to modern missiles, and F-35 falls short on that count.
Number 3.
The trump card of F-35 against any air defense system is that it's a stealthy aircraft. But F-35's simplified airframe is far less of the shaped stealth found in the F-22. This implies a much greater reliance on radar-absorbing materials. Against X-band radars, it's only stealthy from front and rear. Against S-band radar, it's stealthy from narrow front aspect. Against L-band radar, limited reduction is achieved from direct front. Overall, F-35 is much easier to detect when compared to F-22 Raptor. It also must be noted that whenever the weapon bays are opened, the stealth profile is greatly compromised. S-400 have multiple radars which operate in different bands. Apart from traditional radars, S-400 has radars that are capable of detecting stealthy aircraft. The full list of radars are as follows. ALMAZ 92N6E Gravestone Engagement Radar, Redundant NIP 91N6E Big Bird Acquisition Radar, LEMZ 96L6-1 and 9616E Acquisition Radar, 67N6 Gamma DE Acquisition Radars in L-band, 59N6 Protivnik GE Acquisition Radars in L-band, 1119 Nebo SVU in the VHF band, and multiband Nebo M. The NABOB SVN and ZBU M have a claimed capability against stealth aircraft. Keeping in view the different aspects, F-35 will be vulnerable in a combat scenario.
Number 2.
All three variants of the F-35 carry active, electronically scanned array radars with sophisticated electronic attack capabilities, including false targets, network attack, advanced jamming, and algorithm-packed data streams. This system allows the F-35 to reach well-defended targets and suppress enemy radars that threaten the F-35. But S-400 has many features specifically designed to overcome countermeasures and stealth, such as a larger, more powerful radar that's more resistant to jamming. The main radar is a pulse-to-pulse agile frequency hopper to maximize countermeasures resistance. S-400 also has Topaz Kolchuga M KRTP-91 Tamara / Trashcan and 85V6 Onion Vega emitter locating systems. The aim of these components is to engage emitting targets without emitting from the acquisition radars, or if the acquisition radars have been jammed. Hence, EM attack from F-35 will find it hard to disable S-400.
Number 1.
S-400 is designed to be mobile. All system components are carried by self-propelled wheeled all-terrain chassis. This means that the system can pop up at different locations at different points in time. It has an open system architecture with a high level of modularity, intended to permit follow-on capability growth in the design. The radar can be used independently of the missiles for command and control purposes. So just because the radar is there doesn't mean the entire system is there. These aspects make it very unpredictable and difficult to target. Even if detected, S-400 will be a very, very tough nut to crack. Just one S-400 system can control up to 72 launchers with a maximum of 384 missiles. This means that the system has enough ammunition and targeting strength to take down a saturation attack. Also, an important aspect is that for aerodynamic target and ballistic targets, the minimum engagement range is only 2 and 5 kilometers respectively. This means that the targets can be engaged till the last seconds and multiple times. A separate independent air defense system, 42S6 Morphe, is being developed by Russia's ALMAZ Ante Corporation. This system is designed as short-range air defense system and will protect the S-400 from various threats at their terminal faces. It will also act together with the mid-range S-350E Vychaz air defense systems. This means the long-range S-400 will be protected by medium-range S-350E Vychaz and short-range 42S6 Morphe system. Derived from Tor-M2, Morphe has a range of 5 kilometers or 3 miles. It's reported to feature an omnidirectional cupola-type radar with active electronically scanned array. Morphy designed to shoot down precision-guided weapons like the AGM-86 ALCM or Tomahawk cruise missile day and night in bad weather and jamming situation. It can detect targets while on the move. S-400 is not just a standalone system, but a tightly integrated system which has been very purposely designed. Even a dozen of F-35 may find it difficult to take out a single S-400 system. As per our analysis, F-35 will find it difficult to operate in areas protected by S-400. This means that not only US but the partner nations will find it hard to gain air supremacy, which is vital in modern conflicts. Another important aspect is that several countries which are rival to the US, like China, are getting this system from Russia. S-400 will have to be accepted as a game changer and will act as a frontline anti-access and aerial denial system in future combats.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.